joins us now for a full check of your forecast. And Jada, we saw rain across our area today, and it brought some cooler temperatures with it.
It sure did. And as you can see, we still have a few residual showers that are going to move off the coast in the next 30 minutes or so. But as we experience some dryness overnight, we'll be back into it with the thick of the storms for tomorrow. And I'll walk you through that in just a moment. What we're seeing right now as far as temperatures go, 76 most of our low country area in the mid-70s, but we are seeing 72 for Hampton, 72 for Sylvania, here in Savannah and Richmond Hill, 74 moving further inland, 73 for Metter and Vidalia. So we're going to continue to see these low 70s for our lows throughout the rest of this week with that stationary low pressure that's just sitting above us for the next couple of days. So what we are expecting out the door, 68 degrees, quite a cool start to the day. Make sure you do have a light jacket on your way out for church and morning activities. Moving through the day, the first chance of the strongest storm starts right around 11 a.m. We'll see some residual showers here and there throughout the morning, but it starts to kick up right around 11 a.m. just before noon, and through the rest of the night or afternoon into the evening, we start to see those rain showers just continue on. We won't really get much of a let up until around 8 p.m. So those temperatures will get as high as 78 here in Savannah. So it's going to be a rather cool day for us, starting to feel a little bit like fall. So Futurecast is going to show us what that looks like for tomorrow afternoon. We start to see a few showers, and then that shower starts to conglomerate right around the coast in the afternoon. 10 p.m. Sunday, we're going to see the last round of those showers move out, and then by Monday morning, we should be rather clear for the morning commute. Moving into our rain chances for the rest of the week, 40% for Sunday, but as it goes into the week, we take it back to about 30 to 20% each and every day. So keep that umbrella on standby and do be prepared for a wet commute to and from work. Some of these showers will carry over into the next morning, clear up, but be back in the afternoons. Now, as far as the tropics go, we do have quite a lot going on. Around the 8 o'clock update, we did see 50% chance of disturbance one developing within the next 2 days, 70% for the next week. We do have two disturbances here in the Atlantic Basin that are starting to create a bit of a traffic jam right now. Both of them have around 30 to 40% chance of developing within the next week. Looking at our 10-day forecast for the week ahead, like I said, rain chances here and there throughout most of the week, but we are going to sit in a nice, comfortable spot with the mid 80s. For most of our week ahead. Heading into next weekend, we finally get some relief with those rain chances, but most of those lows dip